Hey guys, welcome back. As you can recall, we have imported a list, we have edited a list. Now what I want to do is create a new list and show you something illustrative about tab delimitation. So I create list. So as you remember, you have to give the list a name. Then from default email, this is mandatory, this one is also mandatory. So remind people how they join the list. Then click save. What you want to do is import a list, and this list will have extra fields. Then you'll see how to go about it. So the list we'll be importing is this one. As you can see, we've added a first name, second name, a location, and the title. So how this is done, this is a tab. So you tab in between, the spacing in between it. That's what delimitation is all about. In programming, there's something called delimitation, whereby anything that is being listed or anything that needs to be separated can be delimited by a space, a tab. You can use commas, you can use special characters, like in a sentence. The grammatical way of delimitation is a space. So if you say my name is John, so you'll write my space name space is space John. So the space is what is referred to as a delimitation. In this case, we want to import that list. So import from CSV or text file. List sample, then upload list. You'll see that each item that was delimited by a tab, by the space, becomes its own field. So the email became a field, the first name became a field, the second name became a field. And since there was no way for MailChimp to know the title, it created an unnamed title for them. So this is very simple. You can just edit this, click on edit, then you come here, create a new column, then new column name, let's call this one first name, then you save. New column, second name, save, make a selection, new column, this one is a location. Location, then save. So complete import. You'll notice that there are these fields that we have here from MailChimp by default, but this is easy for us guys now. So we'll just go to setting, click on list fields and merge. The fields that we're deleting is first name and last name there, and type delete. Delete field. Then we still have one more to delete. Delete this one. With that, let's click on save changes. Remember to save each and every time you make any changes here. So manage subscribers, view subscribers. So our list of Bizanosa 2 has only the fields that we need, and we've been able to import everything in a very simple way by just using our txt files and then editing. Once we imported and we realized that there was no title for this, we edited that as well. If you don't need any of these fields, you know how to delete them. Okay guys, thank you. Go to the playlist and watch these videos one by one, and at the end you'll be good at this, and you won't ever find yourself hiring anyone to do this for you. This is something you can do for yourself. Most of these are very simple tasks. That's my goal for this course, actually, to get you doing this for yourself. Thanks guys, until next time.